Quickly capturing your ideas, notes, and tasks are some of the most important use cases of digital productivity apps, no matter if you're on the computer or mobile phone. Notion is a great tool for implementing this system, and in this video, I wanted to show you a simple tutorial on how to implement quick capture into your workspace. I'll be showing you how to do a tasks and notes quick capture with an inbox. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first start with an empty Notion page, and I'm going to go ahead and title this one Quick Capture Notes and Tasks. And I highly recommend going to the top right hand corner, three dots, and then turning on small text full width so that we have more space on the page. The next step is that you can add a cover photo by clicking Add Cover and Change Cover. And here you can choose Unsplash for a huge stock image library. In this case, I'll choose something that is related to desk so that we feel more productive. After that, I'm going to go to here, add icon. In order to add an icon, I'll add something that is this lightning bolt, for example, to capture this quick capture notes and tasks. You're more than welcome to choose whatever icon and cover photo that you see fit. And then the next step is going to be to design the overall layout. So in this page, we're going to have two different sections, one for our quick capture buttons as well as our databases, and then one side for our inboxes. So on this side, we're going to type slash column and choose two columns. And then here we're going to add a callout box by typing slash callout. And we're going to have two callout boxes. So I'm going to go ahead and click the six dots here and then duplicate it. And on this side, we're going to have this cursor click so that we can add our quick action buttons. And I'll already add them here by typing slash button. And then here we can choose an icon. So in this case, I'm going to add two quick action buttons, which is to capture notes and capture tasks. I'll use this plus sign here, and then I'll put add note. And later on, I'll be editing this automation here. The next thing I'm going to add by typing enter here slash button is going to be the adding task button. So I'm going to click here again, the plus sign, and then I'll add task, and then done. So as you can see, it's not configured yet, so it shows up like this. We'll be doing that after adding the databases. So here we're going to have a navigation. So I'm going to go ahead and type navigation, and I'll just bold this so that it looks a little bit nicer here. And then inside here, I'm going to create two databases, one for notes and one for tasks. So this is a very simple system, and you can really build off of this if you'd like. I'm going to keep it as simple as possible so that we can really capture the essence of just having this kind of quick capture system. So the first thing we're going to do is type enter and then slash page to create a new page. And this page is going to be a database page. So I'm going to go ahead and click here and plus new empty database. This one is going to be our notes. And I'm going to type here quick capture so that it's really easy for me to find later. Here, I'm just going to do something very simple. So this one is going to be called view all. And basically, whenever you add a new note here, we're going to think about what kinds of properties make sense for notes. So if I click on the plus sign here, we can choose several properties that we might want. I highly recommend the created time. This is really nice so that it timestamps your notes. And the other thing that can be useful is having temp tags. So I'm going to go ahead and click here, tags. And this is a multi-select property. And you can add things like personal and all these kinds of tags here. You can, of course, add even more properties. The last thing I'm going to add for this one is a checkbox. And this one is going to be called reviewed. So when you have reviewed it, you can check it off, and then it's going to land outside of your inbox. So it's good to have something like this, especially if you want to do a quick capture system. So now that we have this very basic setup here, you can add all kinds of filters, all kinds of sorts, and even more views here. But we're going to keep things really simple. So let's go ahead and add an icon here, and I'll go ahead and add something like this. And if we go back to our main page, now we have this notes quick capture. The next database I'm going to be adding by clicking the plus sign here is a tasks database. So I'm going to go ahead and type slash page again, and create a new database, new empty database, and I'm going to call this one tasks. So this is going to be each task. So just like with notes, we want to just create a very simple task system. If I click the plus sign, we can easily add statuses. So this is really useful for especially task management to have statuses. The other thing that can be useful is a due date. So I'm going to choose a date property and call this one due date. That's basically a very, very simple version of a task list. So if you wanted to add a due date here, you could do so. You can add even more layout views and all of these things, but we're going to keep things very simple. One thing I will do with the task that's a little bit different with the nodes is that I'll at least create two different views, one for incomplete tasks and one for complete tasks. So let's go ahead and rename this one incomplete. We're going to add a filter here so that the status is either not started or in progress. And then I'll make another one by clicking here, duplicate. And then this one is going to be complete. And in the complete one, we're going to change the filter so that it is done like this and save. So now we have incomplete and complete. So now if we go back, we have a very basic notes and a very basic task database. I'm going to change the icon here really quickly to something that is a more like a checkbox that matches the task database. One more thing I'm going to do is rename this quick capture so that again, I can easily find this database. So now we have two databases and two buttons here. Before we add the button functionality, let's go ahead and add the inboxes. So the next step is going to be to create our inboxes. So what inboxes act as is a sort of intermediate place to process your notes and tasks. So that means any notes that you want to refine a bit more, or any tasks that you want to add more context to. So for example, due dates, those are going to go into your inbox. So we're going to go ahead and type slash heading. And I'll choose heading 3 and type inbox and then slash divider. So the first one I'm going to add is the notes inbox. Actually, I'm going to title this one notes inbox slash and then linked view of database. And this is going to allow us to view the database from this side over here. And we want to do the notes. So we're going to look for notes quick capture. And this is the one we want. And then once we have that, I'm going to choose the view of view and then hide database title. So for this notes inbox, what we want to do is we want to see all your notes that have not been reviewed yet. So I'm going to add that filter here, filter reviewed, and I'm going to choose unchecked and save for everyone. So now that we have that, if I click here, it's going to get removed from the notes inbox. I can undo that by typing Command or Control Z, and it's back here. So after the notes inbox, let's go ahead and add another one slash heading 3. And I'm going to go ahead and title this one task inbox slash divider. And then inside here, I'm going to add a linked view database by typing slash linked view. And just with like with the notes, I'm going to look for tasks quick capture. And then here I want to show all of the incomplete tasks, and then I'm going to hide database title. So now we have a notes inbox and a task inbox. Inside the task inbox, we need to determine what kind of actions would make sure that we have processed the task. So that means things like if you don't have any kind of due date, then it should end up in your inbox. The moment you add a due date, you can move it over to your regular view here. So let's go ahead and do that by going to filter, and I'm also going to add a filter where the due date is empty and save for everyone. So now there's not going to be anything in here. So now let's just imagine that we have a new task here to remember to buy bread, and we just quickly added that in. We don't really think about it. And then later when we get home, we can add a new due date here like this, and it gets removed from the task inbox. So this is kind of how the task inbox works. Same with the notes. If we quickly add quick note here, and when we get home, we review that this tag is here and we're really happy with it, then we can tick these off so that we can clear both inboxes. But if we go to the navigation to the notes, we still see the notes here. And if we go to the tasks here, you'll still see all of your tasks here like this. So this is kind of the idea behind the quick capture system. And as you can see, it's very simplified here, but you can add Kanban views, you can add more properties just to make it your own. But this is just for the quick capture system. The next step is going to be these buttons. These are the most important parts of quickly capturing your notes and tasks. In order to configure that, you'll want to click this edit button here. So when the button is clicked, we're going to add a new action to add a page to our notes database. And here is our notes quick capture. The name is going to be untitled. We're not going to add anything to any of the properties. And then the other action is just to open that page. And we're going to open that in page added in center peak and then done. So just to test it, let's say we have a new quick note here. And if we click out, you can see it here. Next, let's do the task button. So if we go here, edit button, when the button is clicked, we want to add a page to the task quick capture database. Name is going to be untitled. We're not going to add anything to the properties. The status could be not started by default. And then we're going to add the action to open the page, the new page added, and then in center peak. And then we can click done. So just to test that one out, let's say that we have a new task. And if we click out, you can see that the new task has been added. As soon as I add a due date for that, when I want to do it, then it's going to remove from the task inbox and I can see all of my tasks in my tasks quick capture. So next, let's go over what this would be like on mobile, as it's one of the most useful ways to do quick capture notes and tasks. So now I have my quick capture notes and tasks open on my Notion app. And as you can see, the buttons make it really intuitive to add new notes and tasks. So if I click add note, it's going to open up that page. I can add a new note like this. And then if I go back, then it's going to be added to my notes. I can also add a new task by clicking a new task. And this is already pretty useful to implement. As you can see, my new task appeared here. So it's pretty simple to use on mobile this way. The other way you can use this is by using widgets. So I would recommend, for example, saving this as a widget so that you can easily access your Notion page to quick capture notes and tasks. So in order to do that, I'm going to click here, edit, and then add a widget. And you should be able to also do this on Android. So that's one of the perks of this widget method. So here we can click Notion. And basically what I want to do is quick access to one of my Notion pages. Other things you can do is show your favorites and all these things. For this purpose, I would recommend this one, add widget. And then if I tap and hold, I can set it up. The workspace is the organized notebook. I'm going to choose that page to show here. For this one, it's going to be called quick capture notes and tasks. And then if I click out, then I should be able to quickly access this no matter where I am, instead of having to look through my Notion app. So that's one way to do it. Notion also has some great updates with shortcuts on iOS. So that's another option you can do by clicking shortcuts. And then what you can choose is to click the plus sign here, and I'm going to choose Notion. And we can create a document without opening it. And then you can choose to create a page with a title to ask each time. Same with the body, and then choose the database that it should go in. So here you can choose the account first. Next, you can choose the workspace. And then you can choose the database. And here, what you can do is to create one for each type of database that you want as a quick capture. So for example, if I want to create the task quick capture, I would click tasks quick capture. And then I would click done. So then what I can do is click here and then share, and then I can show it onto my home screen. So here you can see add to home screen. So now we have this one here, and you can also rename this so that it's not create document. But basically now if you click it open, it's going to prompt you to add the new task. And then I can add some more details here and then click done. And it's basically added that task for me automatically. So we can go ahead and check that. and it should be here, new task. So now you can see all of the new tasks that I've added here, and it's working properly. So I would recommend exploring the shortcuts option here, especially if you're on iOS, and creating these quick captures here, or the simplest solution to use the widget where you can easily just click these buttons to add new notes and new tasks. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that this was useful. If you're interested in having a more fully built out system for notes and tasks, I highly recommend the Ultimate Second Brain Plus Tasks template, which include built-in quick capture buttons. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.